This is Amos Entertainment. The Goddess of Desires.
My name is Philippe and I am from France. It's my sixth time in India.
माँ के अंदर आप अपना विश्वास पैदा कीजिए और अपनी कोई भी बात है वो माँ से ऐसे शेयर कीजिए जैसे आप अपनी माँ से शेयर करते हैं।
माँ बोले तो शक्तिपीठ में एक है।
Great love, great power of love. This is the main thing.
माँ है जगत जननी, उनको कृपा से दुनिया चलते हैं।
माँ आपको बिल्कुल सही रास्ता दिखाएंगी और एक बार जब आप यहाँ आएंगे आप खुद ये चीज महसूस करेंगे कि वाकई में ये एक जागृत शक्तिपीठ है।
मनटा की बोलबो भरे गेलो किछु बोलार नहीं माने मायर काछे चाहे सब समय बार बार आसी।
माँ के लिए तो हमको सोचते नहीं सिर्फ श्रद्धा है पूजा करते हैं उनकी विश्वास है उन पे।
हमरा अनेक देखेसी एखाने ऐसे अनेक आशा पूर्ण हो जाए और होछेओ किंतु सबसे बड़ कथा होल एखानकार जे धारणा যারাই আসবে মায়ের পীঠস্থান একবার অন্তত স্পর্শ করবে মোক্ষ প্রাপ্তি হবে।
Beyond the cycle of life and death, what if your desires, your dreams lead you to the most powerful Shakti-Peeths in the world?
Maa Kamakhya or Maa Kameshwari is actually the goddess of desires. They say whatever your heart's desire is, you should come here and seek mother's blessings. Seek that and mother shall grant you every wish that you have in your heart.
Imagine you had one chance to travel the world, to be at Nilachal, to feel oneness with the gods themselves. Situated on the Nilachal Parvat, Kamrup is where Maa Kamakhya's temple is located. A celebration of female fertility, a Shakti Peeth where the Yoni Mudra of Sati is worshipped, worshipped as the source of all powers. A force of the goddess that has the power to grant you all that your soul seeks. The earliest legends tells us the story of Kamakhya. Kamakhya Dham, where the famous temple of Mother Kamakhya is situated, is located in the western part of Guwahati, atop the Nilachal Hills. The Nilachal is comprised of three parts, the Brahma Hill, Vishnu Hill and the Shiva Hill. The temple is located about 600 feet above the plains. Devotees who visit the temple come to the Sobhagya Kunda to wash themselves of all sins and embark on the journey towards the temple to offer their worship to Mother Kamakhya. They light diyas, incense sticks and join the queue to enter the temple. According to Kalika Puran, when one prays to Goddess Kamakhya with a pure heart, she grants the desired boons within no time.
প্রথম কথা হলো মাকে আমরা যেভাবেই প্রার্থনা করি যারা যেটাকে নিজের নিজের মনের মতো করে প্রার্থনা করতে পারবে আরাধনা করতে পারবে কিন্তু এখানে মায়ের মূল মন্দিরে বিশেষ বিশেষ পূজোর ব্যবস্থা আছে যারা ইচ্ছে করে সেইভাবে বিশেষ বিশেষ পূজো দিতে পারে যেমন মায়ের মূল পূজো বিধিবদ্ধ পূজো দিয়ে মায়ের হোম যজ্ঞ করা হয় মায়ের পূজোর হোম যজ্ঞ করে হয় এখানে সন্ধিপাত হয় আর এখানে মূল কথা হলো এখানে বলিবিধান দিয়েও পুজো হয় বলি করেও পুজো হয় মা কামাখ্যাকে কুমারী রূপে পুজো করার একটা পরম্পরা আছে যারা এসে একটু সময় নিয়ে আসে ওরা কুমারী পূজা করে চলে যায় কেউ কেউ কুমারী ভোজন করে কিন্তু সাধারণত যে হাজার হাজার লোক আসছে ওরা সাধারণত দর্শন করেই চলে যায় দর্শন বলতে এখানে দর্শন না কিন্তু এই মা কামাখ্যার পীঠস্থানে মাকে দর্শন না এখানে মূল পীঠস্থানটা স্পর্শ করতে হয় আর স্পর্শ করলে নির্বাণ প্রাপ্তি হয় মোক্ষ লাভ হয়
Very closely linked with the people's wishes and desires are fulfillments of what their hearts seeked at some point of time. Wishes that came true. These animals that one gets to see in the temple are a reflection of that. You can see pigeons being sold in pairs. They say when one's wishes come true, they come back to the temple to offer their sacrifice. Young pigeons found in plenty thus become symbols of someone else's dreams coming true. You can see goats at times in pairs, some of them waiting to be offered as sacrifice, waiting for their final fate, tied to a pole. But not all of them are sacrificed. Some of them are released. All these animals grow up in the campus. Devotees feed them. They are as much a part of the temple as is everyone visiting the place. God resides in them in the most unusual of ways. When one worships Mahamaya in the Yoni Mandal of Kamakhya, one gets all his wishes fulfilled on earth. He attains the Swarup of Shiva after his death. There is none equal to him. He lives a long life of contention. If a person performs the worship of Mahamaya even once in Kamakhya Yoni Mandal, he obtains 100-fold merits from that worship. Ma Kamakhya is Mahamaya herself. As Ma Kamakhya, she stands on the red lotus placed on Shiva, who is lying on the back of a lion. She grants blessings to her devotees. Ma Kamakhya is one and everything in herself. She is the primordial cause of the universe. She is the embodiment of the world. She is always upheld by Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. Mahadev is the white ghost, Brahma the red lotus, and Hari is the lion. She grants them their wishes and protects the thousands and millions of devotees who come to seek her blessings. Take shelter in her shadow.
আমাদেরকে বলা হয় বরদেউরি মা কামাখ্যার যারা মূল পূজারী বংশের লোক ওনাদেরকে বলা হয় বরদেউরি এই যে বরদেউরি ফ্যামিলি ওরা আদিতে ছিল কনৌজে কনৌজের এক জায়গায় ছিল এখানকার যখন এখানে যখন পাল বংশের রাজত্ব ছিল দশম শতাব্দী কিংবা এগারো শতাব্দী হবে ইলেভেন্থ সেঞ্চুরি হবে তখন আমাদেরকে আমাদের পূর্বপুরুষকে কনৌজ থেকে এখানে নিয়ে এনেছিল পাল বংশের রাজা ধর্মপাল আর মায়ের পুজোর জন্য আমাদেরকে এখানে সেটেল করেছিল
One can see newly married couples come and pray to Ma Kamakhya to seek her blessings for their conjugal life ahead.
We
मेरा यहाँ पे जितना भी फैमिली का जितना भी पर्सन है सबका आशीर्वाद लेके माँ कामाख्या का आशीर्वाद लेके मैं अपना ज़िंदगी नया से स्टार्ट करने जा रहा हूँ। तो मैं यही चाहता हूँ कि माँ कामाख्या और सारा फैमिली मुझे आशीर्वाद दें।
The architecture of Ma Kamakhya Devalaya is a reflection of two distinct art forms, the North Indian style of architecture and the Saracenic Mughal influence. This confluence has been called as the Nilachal style of architecture. The royal patronage in subsequent times left a lasting impression in the architectural designs of the Kamakhya temple. Legends say that the masons sent by Coach King Narayanan from Kuch Bihar failed in their attempt to rebuild the shikhara or the domical part of the temple using stone blocks. Finally, they opted for bricks instead of stone. In fact, the Kamakhya temple is one of the few temples that has a proper ground plan consisting of five chambers: the Garbhagriha, Antarala, Jagmohan, Bhog Mandir, and an Art Mandir. Life-size sculptures adorn the walls of the temple. We see religious sculptures, secular-themed ones, flora and fauna, and geometrical designs on the walls.
ये आपनारा देखे जन सौभाग्य कुंड ये सौभाग्य कुंडे जल परिष्कार जन्नो आम्रा एकटा प्रोजेक्ट नियेछि पानीटा এখান থেকে কুণ্ডু থেকে গিয়ে আবার পরিষ্কার হয়ে আবার চলে আসবে কুণ্ডুতে। আমরা 2016 সালের 1 জানুয়ারি থেকে পুরো কামাখ্যা ধামটা নো তবে কুজুম ইয়ে করে দিয়েছি আর এটাতে আমরা অনেকটা সফল হয়ে গেছি। আর এখান থেকে মানে নরেন্দ্র মোদী যে আমাদের মাননীয় প্রাইম মিনিস্টার নরেন্দ্র মোদীর যে স্বচ্ছ ভারত অভিযান এখান থেকেই শুরু হয়েছে।
The Kamakhya temple premises is an example of Swachh Bharat in itself. Several sevaks of the Devalaya work tirelessly across the clock to keep the temple premises clean, cleaning the floors every now and then, washing the temple walls, using state-of-the-art machines to speed up the work, to ensure the best experience for the devotees. There is almost not a speck of dirt to be found in the temple. There is always someone cleaning up, keeping the temple clean. As the day ends, the crowd lessens. Ma Kamakhya Devalaya glistens with a glow of its own. They say if you look closely enough in a state of meditation, the trident at the top of the dome seems to emit light that connects a pathway to the sky. The peace and tranquility of the compound is unparalleled. The long queues may last for hours. The devotees wait in anticipation, their hearts eager to offer prayers to Ma Kamakhya in the Garbhagriha, where they shall not just have a darshan, but shall also touch the Shakti-Peeth, the Yoni Mudra, epitome of all powers, the embodiment of Shakti itself, procreation. Could it well be that the worship of the Yoni as a symbol of procreation did indeed start from the concept of the ancestral mother? The cult worship of the goddess as supreme deity, could this be a reason that helped bring a confluence of tantricism and shaktism at Kamakhya temple? It is said that Kamdev, the embodiment of love himself, was once reduced to ashes by the fire spewed by Lord Shiva's third eye. Kamdev's wife Rati prayed to Shiva and he advised Kamdev to find the sacred Yoni Mudra of Sati and build a magnificent temple over it. It is said that Kamdev regained his lost beauty after worshipping Mahamaya as Ma Kamakhya. The story of the Shakti-Peeth starts from the story of Daksha's Yagya. At the ceremony, Daksha spoke ill of Shiva in front of the other guests. Sati, unable to bear the insult of her husband Shiva, laid down her own life. This enraged Lord Shiva. Carrying dead Sati on his shoulders, he started performing a tandav. Vishnu tried to pacify him, but failed. Later, he dismembered Sati's body into 51 parts with his chakra. The places where each part fell became Shakti-Peeths.
Well, this place is one of the most powerful Shakti-Peeths that exists, and people come here from all across India and all across the world. It's actually a privilege and honor to be present here, because unless and until Mother really calls you, you cannot be here.